dear student, good morning. Now I am going to take a class of education. This is the third class of education. In third class of education, we are going to discuss what is scope of education. Scope of education. Scope of education. Now we shall discuss about scope of education. What do you mean by scope? What is scope? What is scope? What is scope? Scope means area. Scope means area or range. Scope means area or range. What type of experiences? What type of experiences in teaching learning process? Such types of experiences are included in the scope of education. What is teaching learning process? What is teaching learning process? Teaching learning process. What is teaching learning process? Delivering a lecture. Delivering a lecture. Lecture. In any subject. In any subject. In any subject. In any subject. That's are included. That's are included in the scope of education. There are scope means actually the meaning. Scope of education is very wide or broad. Wide or broad. Scope of education is broad and wide. It is very difficult to explain everything. It is very difficult to explain everything. Explain everything. It is very difficult for us to discuss in details about scope of education. Whatever knowledge may be acquired, or whatever knowledge or experience, knowledge or experience may be acquired. Such types of knowledge and experiences are included in the scope of education. Listen to the blackboard. Try to keep concentration in the blackboard. Actually, whatever we have acquired various types of knowledge, whatever various types of knowledge may be acquired ourselves, and training we receive from knowledge and training received from formal educational institution, or it is actually called received from educational institution. Such types of knowledge and trainings are included in the scope of education. Scope of education. The first one. Whatever knowledge may be acquired, whatever training may be received by ourselves, such types of knowledge and training are included in the scope of education. In the scope of education. Education. Next, teacher teaches the students. Teacher teaches the students. Teacher İçsiz da student. İçsiz da learner or students. Learner or students. Students. Learner or students. Teachers. Teachers. Thus I have mentioned thoroughly the scope of education. Teachers teaches the learners or students. Students. Teachers personality directly. Teachers personality. Personality. Directly. Directly influences. Directly influences. Influences. Directly influences the learner. The learner. Or the students, learner or students, the same thing, learners or students. So, role of teachers, so, role of teachers, so, role of teachers, his role of teachers, role of teachers, role of teachers, role of teachers, his personality, personality, personality, his personality, characteristics, characteristics, characteristics, characteristics, characteristics, role of teachers, his personality, characteristics, characteristics of an ideal teacher, of an ideal teacher, of an ideal teacher, ideal teacher, ideal teacher, ideal teacher, ideal teacher, all are under scope of education, scope of education, scope of education, scope of education. This is included, these are included in the scope of education. Next, regarding to teach the sign of teacher, to teach the sign, a teacher should know his students. When a teacher is going to deliver his lectures, going to deliver his lectures, during that time, the teacher should have knowledge about learner. What is the motive? What is the interest, what is the motive of the learner, what is the interest of the learner, the teacher should know this. Knowing students means to know the intelligence, to know the intelligence, to know the intelligence, intelligence, intelligence, intelligence, interest, attention, interest, attention, interest, attention, interest, attention. These are all included, these are all included, these are all included under the scope of education. Do you understand or not? When a teacher is delivering his lectures, or when the teacher comes to the classroom, during that time, the teacher should know about the students. That means knowing the students means actually it is such types of capacity through which the teachers knowing the students means to the intelligence, interest, attention, etc., etc. of the learner included under the scope of education. So many points are included here. No need to explain in details, or it is not possible to discuss in details through online classes. Let us thoroughly know that scope means ultimately what happened. What do you mean by scope of education? Scope means these are so many points, but thoroughly you should know that scope means scope of education means scope means area, range. That means area or range means whatever experiences may be acquired, may be learned, may be acquired ourselves. Such types of experiences or knowledge are included in the scope of education. This is the scope of education. If any problem regarding the scope of education, then you may contact us. Now, next we shall discuss about types of education. Types of education. Next. Types of education. Types of education. Types of education. These are so simple types of education. Regarding types of education, listen to the blackboard, pay attention in the blackboard. These are so easy. Regarding types of education, there are three types of education. There are three types of education. Three types of education. Three types of education. Number one, formal education. Number two, non-formal education. That means informal education. And lastly, it is non-formal education. These are three types of education. Now we shall discuss about what is formal education system. Already you have acquired so many experiences, so many knowledge from your textbook. Various types of experience, various types of knowledge already you have acquired through your textbook. These are all included in the formal systems of education. It is actually formal systems of education, it is like institutional formal education. Whatever knowledge may be received from whatever knowledge or experience may be received by the learners, by the students, it is called actually formal systems of education. Whatever knowledge or experience may be received by the learners from educational institution, It is called formal education system. Formal education system is deliberate process. It is planning system. It has pre-planned. It is deliberate process. Deliberate process. Formal systems of education. Whatever knowledge or experiences may be received ourselves from educational institution that means school, from school, colleges, universities, and provide degree, diploma, and certificate. And provides degree, diploma, and certificate. These are all included in the formal system. These are all included, or it is called formal systems of education. In formal systems of education, we have acquired. In formal systems of education, we have acquired degree, diploma, and certificate. Suppose, as for example, you are now in HS first year. You have already got admission in HS first year. Why you have got admission in HS first year? Because you have a certificate provided by council, provided by SEBA. Why a SEBA provided a certificate to you? Because you have already appeared in HSLC examination. HSLC examination. And those who are passed in HSLC examination, then You got a certificate. And mark sheet. So it is possible to get admission in HS first year. Such types of certificate, mark sheet, will be provided by educational institution. It is included in the formal systems of education. In formal systems of education, there are some rules and regulations. We obey some discipline in formal systems of education. Rule, regulations, discipline, etc. included in the formal systems of education. There are some rules and regulations in formal systems of education. Formal systems of education is regulated by planned and definite timetable. That means it has some definite timetable. It has ending system. It is started at formal systems of education started at 6 years. Formal systems of education started at 6 years. That means it has starting point. It has starting point. When formal systems of education started, that means when the child becomes 6 years, during that time formal education should be start. And formal systems of education, it has ending process, starting process and ending process. It will be started at 6 years and it will be finished Formal education should be finished at 23 years. 3 years. How? How it can be possible? Let us explain this in details. Suppose 6 years formal education should be started and ending 23 years. How? From 6 years to 16 years. 16 years. From 6 years to 16 years. That means in 6 years you will add class 1. Class 1. Class 1. Class 1 to 10. It is duration of this class 10 years. 10 years. So when you appear HSLC examination, HSLC examination, during that time your age is 16. Why? Because education started at 6 years and the secondary level of education, or that means formal systems of education, from class 1 to class 10, 10 years. 6 plus 10 is equal 6 plus 10 is equal 16. That means when you have appeared in HSLC examination during that time, your age is 16 years. Next, it's a first year, second year. Now you are in the first year. 2 years. It's a first year, second year, 2 years. That means 18 years. 18 years. Next, after age, higher secondary level, HS, SMC, when you have passed, when you will be appeared in HS, SLC examination, during that time, your age is 18 years. After pass the HSLC examination, 2 years, after 2 years, your age will be 18 years. Next, after HSLC examination, degree. Degree means TDC or degree, or it is called actually BA BSc. Degree first year, second year, and third year. Degree first year, second year, and third year. That means 3 years. 18 plus 3, now 21 years. 21 years. And lastly, after completing the degree, now it is called UG, undergraduate, UG. JBSC is called actually UG, undergraduate. 3 years. 18 plus 3, 21 years. And after that, PG, postgraduate. Postgraduate, that means MA. MA. MA means 2 years. MA first year, second year. First year, second year. MA, the duration of MA, 2 years. 2 years means 21 plus 2 is equal 23 years. Already, through this system, we should know that formal education system started at 6 years and it will be finished at 23 years. These are all included in the formal systems of education. Do you understand or not? Formal education system, it has timetable. It has fixed timetable. It has starting point. Or it has ending system. Age limitation. Timetable, starting point, ending system, that means it has age limit. It has age limit. Age limitation is also there in formal systems of education. There are framework of curricula. There are framework of curricula. There must be curriculum in formal systems of education. Framework of curriculum. So that framework of curriculum, various types of subject may be provided to you. Suppose it says as framework of curriculum, that means framework of curriculum, that means various types of subject may be provided to you. Suppose in HS first year, now various subjects are taken by yourselves. English, alternative English will be MIL. MIL means various types of MIL, Assamese, Bodo, Hindi, Manipuri, etc. etc. MIL. Next, education, political science, ESC, political science, logic and philosophy, history, geography, geography, economics, anthropology, sociology, etc. etc. These are framework of curriculum. There must be framework of curriculum in formal systems of education. There are three elements are here in formal systems of education. Three factors are shares. These are actually educator. Educator means teacher. Educator, teachers, educant, learner, or pupil and curriculum. These are included in the formal systems of education. This is called formal systems of education. Do you understand or not? Next, we shall discuss about informal education system. Informal education. Informal education means it is actually used in wide sense, used in broad sense. Education which received outside the formal educational institution. Formal educational institution that means schools, colleges, and universities. It involves broad meaning or wide meaning. Whatever experience may be acquired ourselves through any situation or according to demand of the situation, whatever knowledge may be acquired ourselves, it is included in the informal systems of education. In informal education system, there is no age limit.
There is no age limit. There is no boundaries. There is no any boundaries. Boundaries. There is no any limitation. There is no any limitation. In formal systems of education, there are some limitations. But in informal education system, there is no any limitation. Or there is no age limit. Or there is no any boundaries. There are no any rules and regulations. There are no any rules and regulations. Rules and regulations. Rules and regulations. There is no any discipline. There is no any discipline. Discipline. There is no any pre-planned curriculum. Pre-planned curriculum. There is no any pre-planned curriculum. There is no any framework of curriculum. Framework of curriculum. Framework of curriculum. Framework of curriculum. Framework of curriculum. These are all included in the informal education system. That means ultimately we can say that whatever knowledge and experiences, I have already mentioned it. Whatever knowledge and experiences may be acquired ourselves according to demand of the environment, according to demand of the situation, such types of knowledge and acquired are included in the informal systems of education. Actually, in informal education system, there is no any fixed timetable. There is no any fixed timetable. Fixed timetable. There is no any fixed timetable. There is no educational institution. There is no educational institution. Institution. There is no any educational institution. Courses of studies. There is no any courses of studies. Courses of studies. Courses of studies. That means no limitation. No boundaries here. No fixed timetable. No educational institution. No courses of studies. Whatever knowledge may be acquired in any situation, according to demand of the situation, such types of experience, such types of knowledge included in the informal education system. In informal systems of education, another important point is here. In informal education system, certificate, degree, diploma will not be provided. Certificate, degree, diploma, diploma will not be provided. Certificate, degree, diploma not provided in the informal education system. Through various types of other institution, through various types of other institution like Namghar, magazine, TV, through TV we have acquired various types of experiences, through magazine we have acquired various types of through magazine various types of experience may be acquired, through libraries, various types of experience may be acquired, by radio, various types of experience or knowledge may be acquired, through Namghar, Mandir, Masjid, SARS, stars. Stars. Gurudwar, mosque, etc. These are various types of media. Through this media, we have acquired various types of experiences and knowledge. These are whatever knowledge and experience may be acquired through such types of media. These are all included in the informal systems of education. That means informal education, that means as a whole we can say that informal education system, that means whatever knowledge and experiences may be acquired according to demand of the situation, according to the demand of the environment, such types of knowledge are included in the, such types of knowledge or experience are included in the formal, informal systems of education. This is called actually informal systems of education. Do you understand or not? Next, we shall discuss about non-formal education system. Non-formal education system. Types of education, already we have discussed formal education system, informal education, and now we start non-formal education system. What is non-formal education system? Thus I have mentioned thoroughly. Due to the explosion of knowledge, population explosion, and desireless expansion of ambition, expansion of ambition or desireless or willingness, desireless or willingness. Explosions of knowledge, population explosion or expansions of ambition, desireless or willingness. Due to these three elements, three factors, day by day, competition is going on in our society. So, whatever knowledge may be acquired through formal systems of education, that means you have acquired already bookish knowledge, various types of bookish knowledge. But these are not sufficient in our life. Why these are not sufficient in our life? Because due to the explosions of knowledge, due to the population explosion and expansions of ambition, due to these three factors, whatever knowledge may be acquired ourselves through our formal systems of education, these are not sufficient in our life. So another system may be introduced to acquire various types of knowledge and experiences through, it is called actually non-formal education system. Non-formal education system, that means it is like a formal system, but it has also framework of curriculum, it has also pre-planned system, but so formal systems of education is a starting point, but in non-formal education there is no starting point. Due to the various types of condition in our society, a group of learners are deprived from their formal systems of education. These are called actually dropout children. These dropout children, if they are interested to learn something in their life, at any age, they can enter into non-formal education system and acquire various types of degree, diploma and certificate from non-formal education system. It has deliberate and systematic. It is deliberate process and systematic. It has no strict discipline. It has no strict rules and regulations. Rules and regulations and disciplines are there, but not these are strict rules and regulations, discipline, etc., etc. From non-formal education system, at any age, we can acquire various types of experience and acquire degree, diploma, and certificate. There is no any difference. Whatever certificate, degree, diploma may be acquired through formal systems of education and through non-formal systems of education. There is no any difference nowadays. So, nowadays non-formal education is very essential in our daily life. Non-formal education, that means at any age, we can acquire, we can gain certificate, degree, diploma, at any age. If we interested to learn more, so nowadays non-formal education is very essential. Let us stop today. Next we shall discuss about. Let us stop today. Thank you.